This is 25 to Life with Uncle Yahshua.
Slums, the rats, the roaches, the bums, the metal that stuns, the addicts, the cracks, the crumbs, the level where funds gets tragic and lavish as none. With rebels, they runs and rabbits like savages' sons. With did him and bigger and swiftly he shined the mud. That city appeared it with 50 took 9 of them slugs.
This is 25 to Life with Uncle Yahshua.
At the beginning of hip hop, guys, the microphone was dangerous. If you wasn't a killer or about that life or have an official stamp or have people to know who you are, you better not touch that microphone. Yeah, that's right. You did start rhyming. That's right.
Did they put on
the Queens there? All right, now let me get to the story, Daddy. I gotta get to the story. So now we the 98 Posse, they meet up, right? So we at the park, Campbell Park. We at the park, the strip where I tell the story about Bismarck from the documentary. Y'all learn about that. So niggas is like, yo, we about to go to Queens. Niggas is doing a block party for the basketball game, the late night. Oh. Now, what I'm trying to let y'all know is these niggas would play the game would be 2 o'clock in the morning, guys. This is New York streets history facts. Southside Queens get in the building. The basketball games would be 2-3 o'clock in the morning, my G's. This summertime in New York City. This ain't basketball games at 8 in the afternoon. We're talking 2 and 3 o'clock in the morning, my G's. Listen clearly. So They're playing the basketball game and the DJ is loud. This shit is a park jam at 2-3 o'clock in the morning. Fast. Loud. Lights, cameras, action. Hundreds of people. Now, Supreme Team and Fat Cat and them and all other gangsters, they got all their cars lined up. When you go to the entrance to the basketball court, you talking 500 SELs, like all these Ferraris, Porsches. They got all these cars, these exotic cars. These niggas making millions. I'm gonna keep it real with y'all. We making thousands. Them niggas was making millions. That's a fact. We was 98. This before we went foreign. This is before we went foreign, start buying my Benzes and my Audis and all that. We start buying Jettas and Porsches and Zs. This
we before they leave, really.
Well, yes. Everybody followed. But first of all, the first people to go foreign was Poe and Rich and them. Yeah. Harlem. Them niggas was the first ones to go foreign. Yeah. Brooklyn and Queens and Long Island, we were still rocking 98s and Caddies. Yeah. Yeah. Harlem niggas was the first niggas to go foreign. AZ and them with them 745 BMWs and everything.
Can't Queens get the money.
Word. So far as Brooklyn and Queens and Long Island, the Queens niggas, Premium was going foreign. And then we took daily. Because I remember seeing Premium, and next you know, we start going foreign. Niggas start buying 7 Series Beamers and Benzes and Audis, and we start going foreign. But at this point, we ain't foreign yet. We still got the 98s. So now we pull up to the park, mad cars. Now here's the story. So we on the island, we at Campbell Park. Niggas like, yo, we going to Queens. We, in my car, the Nasty Four, we already know where they going. We done been there. See, niggas, a lot of them in the 98s going there for the first time. We've been going there all the time. We've been there 5 times since the game started this summer. They don't know that, though. They don't know we go everywhere. I'm talking about all through Queens, all through the Bronx, all through Brooklyn. We everywhere. Everywhere. They don't know it, though. And we in your hood, though. We in your hood, in your party. And we getting on the mic. That's something else you don't know. The mic. See, what y'all know about the beginning of the Hempstead, that mic was a dangerous thing. I mean, the beginning of hip hop. At the beginning of hip hop, guys, the microphone was dangerous. If you wasn't a killer or about that life or have an official stamp or have people to know who you are, you better not touch that microphone. You will not make it out of that party, that club jam, that block party, that club. You touch that microphone, you better have somebody, you better have a bunch of goons behind you. You better have a bunch of people stamping you. You better be, the microphone was a death sentence. That mic was a death sentence. If you grab that mic, niggas will rip, I don't know, it was like being on the mic.
It's like you fighting.
Yes, it was like you fighting. It was like you going to a place and standing up and saying, I'm the baddest nigga in this whole town. It's like you going to somebody's hood and standing up in their hood and they get on their project and say, I'm the baddest nigga in this whole hood. And niggas is going to come and bring it to you. That's what that mic was about. Yeah. So you better not touch nobody's microphone. This is back in the day. Everybody know original hip hop, know what I'm talking about. Niggas get punched in the mouth. Niggas get dragged. Niggas is clothes stripped off them. All that from touching that microphone. Your crew too. You get wet. All right? Now, I'm letting y'all know, we touching that mic. I'm saying it so y'all can understand the whole context. We ain't just coming to your hood. We ain't just getting out the car and parking, coming in the park, in the club, in the whatever. We also getting on that mic. Nasty Four is getting on the mic, and we are the reason why our name is Nasty. It ain't because of me messing with girls. Yeah. We are the nastiest niggas in the world on the mic. We will rip you to shreds. Because when women is you'll be diminished by the Nasty Four MCs. You might as well beat it because you've been defeated from the Nasty Four MCs. Yes, we demand it because you can't stand it from the Nasty Four MCs. Facts. We ripping you to shreds, okay? Facts. When we get on the mic, listen clearly. When we grab the mic, the reason why they didn't rush us and try to take our and stick our guns on us and everything, because everybody's mouth is, they too busy like this. They too busy like listening. Nigga, when we finish with the mic, niggas is like, yo!
Niggas is nice.
Them niggas is nasty. That's where we got the name from.
That's what's more. As I get older, that's what it like saved our lives. Cause you remember, bro. I mean, we used to walk in parties and niggas just used to stop and like just be mugging it. Da da da. You like. Yeah, yo, you see all these bitches in here? Yo, it's a party. Yo, what's wrong with this nigga?
What's wrong with this? Everywhere we go, niggas be like, they want to hang out. We're always looking at the women, though. We like all these women. Yeah, like, yo, we y'all mean bugging us.
A party, yo. You supposed to have a good time, and yo, what the fuck?
We supposed to have a good time. They want a green.
Man, y'all look at me, yo. You don't look at other men. So it's like
the funny thing, guys.
Don't is it into damn lie, man. Yo, what fuck, man, yo.
Daddy, you, the reason why they were mad is because they knew that all they chicks was liking us, so they didn't want us to get on the mic, because all the women run to the front of the stage, all the women run to the mic, and everybody. So anyway, let me continue, Daddy. Let me continue. Yeah. So now, I'm setting the stage for y'all to get understand. I got to set the whole context so y'all have the whole understanding. So when I say what I'm about to say, y'all can understand the brevity, what it really means. So now, them niggas is like, we going to the 40 projects, Southside Jamaica, Queens. They having the basketball game, and they having a block party jam at the park. They don't know we already been going there. See, that's the thing. Our 98 Posse, our strong, our Hempstead nigga, not strong, our Hempstead nigga. Stick card, right? Our crew, they don't know that we already been gone, but now we the 98 Posse, right? So niggas is like, all right, let's go. So now I remember this clearly. When my crew started to pile in my car, I remember I look at Daddy U. I'm like, yo, Daddy U, we about to go to 40 Project. Daddy U look at me like, yo, I'm about to grab a mic. That nigga looked at me like, good, nigga, we about to rip this shit down.
Yo, go ahead, God, you go.
Oh, I remember that shit. I remember looking at you, Unique. I remember when you said it. I looked at you. I said, this experience is a motherfucker. I knew I said this because I know this nigga's serious. He looked at me. That's the only thing came out of his mouth. Nigga, we about to rip this shit down. Like, I knew. Now, what y'all got to understand, we've been there before, right? So we've been there before, and it was a dangerous thing to try to grab that mic. So we was there enjoying ourselves, right? We've been there enjoying ourselves. But we never really got to grab that mic up until that stage, only because we were getting closer and closer and closer to the mic type of thing. Because it's a crowd, you got to get to that mic, and then niggas all from Queens, and you get that mic, the whole party
they
gonna sit it on.
They just
giving you the mic.
Yo, me and his brother, when we first started out, we used to go to parties, and he stand on one side, I stand on the other side of a speaker, and move that shit, boom, and hide behind that motherfucker. Because
they used to kick us out the party.
Yeah.
Because I was too young.
Fuck that.
I was a little kid.
It's like, let me get the mic. We had to elevate.
You had to get the mic.
What Uncle Yah talk about? That was, if we rock this shit right here, fuck that. Go ahead.
We get the mic. Nah. Okay. So he's telling you hip hop packed the fact that mic was a treasure possession. You just ain't getting the mic. You'll get yourself killed trying to get somebody to get that microphone. Fact. You ain't making it out of that party. That whole party, you'll be stomped out. Ooh. Oh, yes. And you ain't get official. If you whack, it's a rap. Now, so what y'all don't know is we had already been slowly inching our way to getting that mic at that 40 Projects Park. At that park in the 40s, we was already. So this is what I'm trying to tell y'all. When my crew, the 98 Posse, when they was like, yo, we about to go. And I told Unique, and I was like, yo, come on, guys. I was like, yo, come on, we about to bounce. We going to the 40s. They having a, I remember Unique's face. He looked at me and he said, we about to rip this shit down. And I looked and I said, this nigga, he said, I'm about to get this mic. I said, oh, shit. Unique, and I knew he was just zoned in. He like, I don't care about what these niggas going there to smoke weed or going to get chicks. I'm going to get this mic. We about to rip this 40 Projects down right now. And I was like, okay, what I knew, and I had a gun, right? I had a little 38 special, because we don't go nowhere with our guns. This is the heyday time. So I knew that, okay, This could get ugly. It's going down because Unique is going to get this mic and it's going down, right? So now I gave y'all that context. Okay. So we pull off. We head from Long Island Hempstead to Southside Jamaica, Queens. That's all of 10 minutes, just so y'all can have context on the highway. And that's right there. Highway. We right off the doggone highway. Get on Southern State. We right off. Or America, the belt, or wherever we're going to take the belt, whichever way we want to go to Southside, to go to Sufkin Boulevard. All right. So, whichever way we want to go, we right there. Okay. Basically. So it's only 10 minutes, literally 10 minutes. So we jump on the highway. We 30 deep, 98 Posse, all flavors. We in the green and white one, Mac Daddy. We all riding out, smoking blunts music. We pull up. As we pull up, we get to the strip. You see you can see people, you hear the music. Yeah. Boom, 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 boom.
Niggas
on the basketball court, live. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. It's 3 o'clock in the morning, guys. It's the summertime at night. All right, New York City at its finest. Southside, we're in Queens, Jamaica, Queens. So we pull up. You see all the chicks. You see people walking from all parts of Queens, walking to the jam. You pull up, you see all the cars. You see all these gangsters out there, Supreme and all of them. You see all their cars. I know them. We already know because I see all the cars, the Benzes, the Porsches. I'm like, woo, look at these cars. So we pull up. We about 30 deep, 98 Posse. As we drive down the street, everybody, because, we got loud, everybody can see all the cars. So you see everybody in the park like 98 Posse here. Everybody That's what Chuck D was talking about us, right?
You see these car keys, you'll never get these. They belong to the 9A Posse.
You see the car keys, you'll never get these. They belong to the 9A Posse. You see the car keys, you'll never get these. They belong to the 9A Posse.
That's what Chuck D was talking about us, right? So we pull up. Now, as we pull up, this is a true story. I don't care who don't like it. It's a fact. You don't like it, then you shouldn't have did it. I'm going to tell the truth no matter what. I'm just keeping it real. I always kept it real. I have love for everybody, but I've never been a front dude. All right?
Very rare. It's lovely.
Facts. And you know, Hempstead do a lot of fronting on each other. I never fronted on nobody. I always said, I'm not the toughest. I am not the baddest. You crazy? We had H. We had Steve Lawrence. We had, you know, we got so many legends.
Rest
we had
peace G. To both brothers.
You feel me? We got so many street legends. You got Tego and them from the Heights. You got so many legends in them that put it down. You know what I mean? You got Kenny Lewis and them. You know what I mean? You got legends. You feel me? That put it down from where I'm from. So I'm not acting like, but I was no slouch. I was no punk. I come from up under it. We was about that life. Facts. So I'm just keeping it real. This is what happened. I need to do that because I'm going to keep it raw. I don't care what nobody think or say. This is history and facts. So we pull down the street. We 30 deep, 9-8 posse, all flavors, all colors. This is a fact. We pull. We driving. We in my car. We in the green car. Niggas in my car got the window down like, yo, baby. Yo, mama. Yo, niggas already hanging out the window trying to get. Yo, man, my car, wow, man. These niggas, I swear to y'all, these niggas drive and they drive and they drive and we get to the front of the park to go to that basketball court, the entrance, and I'm thinking these niggas about to stop, right? So stop all the cars right there because all the girls were at the entrance to the park. Why these niggas keep going? These niggas drive, and we pulling up, we looking at the entrance and we ready to stop the car and I'm like, what the hell, where they going? These niggas keep going past the entrance of the park. The entrance of the park is here. They keep going. They keep going. I'm like, where are they going? All the chicks is right here. So we they keep driving, right? So we looking in my car, niggas looking back. So we driving away from the girl. I'm like, these niggas are driving away from the entrance to the thing. So niggas in my car. So Unique, you like, wow, stop the car. I'm driving. Let me out. Let me out. Wow. This nigga trying to open the door. I'm like, chill out. You think I don't know where these niggas going around. Let me out. So I'm like, yo, this is the funniest thing in the world, right? So I'm like, yo, he like, Rob, let me out. So I'm like, I stopped the car. Now, when I stopped the car, I'm stopping the line of the 98 posse going because they could. So the niggas behind me stop, right? They're like, bro, what you doing? Because they want to follow the rest of the night. Yeah. Unique opened the door and got out. That nigga said, let me out. That nigga said, let me out. I don't know where these niggas is going, but the party's over here. These niggas leaving all the chicks over here. I don't know where these niggas going. So I let him out. So Unique gets out the car. Fine. He get out, slam the door, boom, and he take off. Go right around the car, and he headed back towards the entrance of the park. We had Southside Jamaica Queens at the 40s. Now, this is true story facts. Now, listen clearly. So he closed the door. We pull off again because niggas behind me blowing. Yo, Rob, catch up to them. I'm like, these niggas. What? So now we pull off. Now we in our catch up to them. So the entrance of the park is here. They go past it, right? They go past it. So these niggas park and they circle the cars all around down here. And they all get out the car. And they all got their music knocking and they all start dumping blunts and they start like smoke. And I'm like, that's what we doing this 25 to life test. Real story.
Life.
Facts. Now listen clearly. I'm like, so niggas in my car, niggas is like, yo, Rob, I know we ain't staying. I know it. I said, nigga, y'all know damn well I'm not staying here. So niggas is like, so then we park, because niggas park the car, they got their car running, systems knocking, because Bill Blast had the loud system. Everybody, they niggas got loud systems, right? So niggas get out, system knocking. So we get out of my car, right? So we get out, so I'm like, yo. So we go to where everybody grouped up, and they busting open blunts to roll blunts and stuff. White Owls, this is White Owls. I think it's before Philly Blunts, right? Yeah, they busting big White Owls down, right? So I'm like, so my car pull up, so I'm like, yo, what y'all doing? The niggas like, nothing, we chilling. So I'm like, man, fuck. Pardon my leg. I'm like, man, huff this. So I look at my niggas. My niggas like, yo, Rod, let's go. So I was like, ah, right, you know what? I hit my man behind me. I'm like, yo, back up a little bit. Give me room. Because we was all parked around each other. So I was kind of blacked in a little. I said, back up a little. He's like, yo, Rod, where you going? Nigga, I'm going. We going to the party, nigga. I didn't understand it. So this is a fact. So then my man, I forget who it was. He backed his car up. My crew, we got back in our car. Now, remember, we ain't the toughest. All right? We ain't the toughest. We just, I don't know. It's just how we built up our heart or something. We get in the car. I turn that car right around, and I go right back to where the entrance of the park where all the chicks was, where all the Queens niggas was, where all Supreme and all them niggas, all the gangsters with all they Benzes, all that was. I pulled my green and white Pimp Daddy 98. I pulled that thing up. Nigga was like, yo, Rob, they're going to park the spot right there. We pulled that joint right into the parking spot. Guys, pulled that thing in. Niggas look. So niggas seen. Niggas seen the 98 posse go and go past. And they could see them way up the street. They seen this green and white one double and come back. Trust me, those niggas seen it. So niggas is looking at the car. They seen it, so they looking at the car like, okay, what is they doing? Because I know those Queen niggas probably like, what is these niggas doing? They might be trying to set us up, you know, set it, right? Because I could see niggas looking and like gripping up, like, what is these niggas doing? So we parked the car. We got out the car. When we got out the car, I parked the car. You walk out the car, you got to go up because it's a street. It's a big, wide street. You got to walk up to go to the entrance of the park, and all them niggas is there. So as we walking up, I'm looking at the niggas and I'm letting them know from my demeanor that it's all good. You know, we ain't coming to be. Like, we just coming to enjoy the party. So I'm letting them know with my demeanor that I'm not coming for no BS, right? So I'm walking, I'm just looking at them and I'm not looking those grill, no school face. Them niggas looking, I'm like, it's all good. Like, we just come to chill. Now listen clearly. So we walk up, the niggas look at us, we look at them. And I could tell, they could tell from my demeanor, my face, like it's all good. Some niggas like, you know, they kind of like, so I could see some of the soldiers look at some of them because Corley and them was there too. So I remember Corley is a pretty light-skinned nigga. And I remember poor Corley had the hottest bins out there at that time. Mm-hmm. So I remember they looked and he was like, let them go. You know what I mean? So niggas looked, I was like, that's what's up. Because they could tell, it's like, nah, we not come for beef. And I know them niggas knew that's the 9A posse. Right? So it's a fact. This is a true story. We walk. As we walk past them to go to the entrance to get to where the basketball court is and with the DJ and all that, I swear to you, this is what I hear. I swear to you on everything. I hear 1-2-1-2. Nasty form scenes in the motherfucking house. The nasty. I said, oh, shit. I swear. I was like, oh, shit. And it's loud because it's the outside party, so you can hear the way I know the 98 posse niggas, so because they said something like, y'all niggas.
Yo, check it out. Know who passed me the mic?
Who?
LL Cool J.
LL was in there?
LL Cool J passed me the mic. Word is born to the father.
Wow. See, I don't know, guys, because we didn't even make it. Unique was already in there.
I'm going to get the mic. I mean,
Unique said he was going to get the mic, but we was at the Parkside Project.
I came here to get the mic, man, yo, man. Fuck it.
This nigga got the mic. Y'all think I'm lying? This is a true history fact, guys. The nigga said, Rod, let me out. Right? The nigga got out the car. I forgot about him. He's gone. I'm thinking Unique on there. He's doing this thing. He's going to be messing with some chicks. I'm thinking Unique about to come with 4 or 5 chicks and bring back your ride. You know what I mean? I ain't thinking. I'm worried about them niggas not going. So we went and parked the car. We went past the Supreme Team niggas, Corley and them niggas, right? They gave us the okay. I let them niggas go in, right? So we walked. Before we could get through, I swear to y'all, all I hear is 1-2-1-2. And I know the nigga voice. Just from the 1-2-1-2, I knew it. Sir, 1-2-1-2. I'm like, my eyes like nasty four in the motherfucking ass. Yeah. See, I just said, oh my, like, boom, head blown. This nigga said, yo, Raw, yo, come to the mic.
Yeah.
Come to the mic. Yo, I swear to you, we trying to make our way through the, it's so funny. We trying to make our way through the crowd. The crowd is crazy. Ain't they going crazy? This thing Unique, like, yo, Nasty Boy, this motherfucker. Yo, we representing it. He doing all this thing. I didn't know LL gave him, I know nothing. All I know, by the time we got to try to get to him, they took the mic. They took the mic.
Yeah. They doing a Queens jam.
Okay, go ahead. Tell the story.
Yo, I'm up there. I'm like, boom. I just, you know how I do? I just chat. I'm like, man, boom. Like this, boom. I'm like, yo, where LL gave the mic. You know, he was saying, yo, you know, he wasn't really trying to, like, you know, beast the mic. I'm trying to beast that shit. Nigga, I want that mic. I'm going to do everything, anything possible to get that mic. Nigga, if you give me that mic, every time I get the mic, like, yo, Rajon, come to the stage.
He always do that.
I call my team.
That's the first thing he always said.
Oh, I'm like, yeah, where the fuck these niggas at? You know what I mean? Because I know they let me out the car. I don't even know if these niggas is in this motherfucker.
Yo, we wasn't in the party yet. We wasn't in the party yet.
But man, yo, it's like, yo, hey, yo. The niggas like, yo, the nigga L like, yo, man, bro, pass me the mic. The niggas
LL like, Cool J said, he said, LL Cool J passing the mic.
I said, yo, we got the 98 posse in here. That's yep. Before. Yo, we're right.
I remember that.
I said,
yeah, that's right. You did start rhyming. That's right.
Did they put on
the Queens there?
Yeah, let's put on the green. 13 is a back, a fat coat sack. Team fiends and dirty jeans keep a fucking fat. Shit hot on my block when the nigga gets shot. Cause round the ghetto, shit never forgot. Nigga house, he put props on the block big time, but he got locked. Stitching the pool with a cop. Strong IPSG, that's where you find me. Uncle A South Franklin, the 2 o'clock store. Crown Ice Grand Daddy, the Hilton Nasty Four.
Hold on, Daddy. I remember now, you're so right. Because they threw on the Queens Jam. Guys, the Queens Jam, we called it, they named that Queens Jam. It's the 50 Cent used it in his new.
I know heartbreaks, setbacks. Bitch, if I crap out, I'm sure I'ma get back. I've been through the ups and downs. You know I get around, so to me, it's all a part of the game.
Yeah, he used it in what? Which one is that? Not Power.
For sure,
the one
Power Two.
The one with the young dude when they go back in the day.
Power Two.
It's Power Two. Yeah, he used it to start it over.
I know heartbreaks. I know setbacks.
That's it. He used it. The reason why he used it, because that was the Queens Jam. We called it. That's not the name of the record. I think that's Luther Vandross and somebody record. We called it Queens Jam.
Everybody called that's the Queens Jam.
That's what everybody called it because Queens must have been the first ones who started rocking it. Because everybody called it the Queens Jam. I don't know if niggas in the Bronx called it that, but Brooklyn, Queens, or Long Island.
Everybody call that shit the Queens Jam. Nigga for the Bronx, Queens, Brooklyn. That's the Queens Jam.
I remember, Daddy, you right. They put on the Queens Jam. DJ, who now?
Yo, you telling me? I didn't even know that was.
You didn't know that was. Bruh, I did.
No, I didn't know.
Yeah, I found it. Yes, I knew it was her.
But I'm like, yo, I listened to his shit when he was like, yo, I was doing, man, yo, but I was just doing shit in the park. But I never connected the dots.
He was the one that was officially designed. Because you could, guys, in hip hop, you couldn't just bring out equipment, you couldn't grab the mic. You couldn't DJ in a park. You will be dead. They will take all your equipment. So you had to be officially stamped. So Supreme Team has stamped.
Yeah, man,
you didn't even know that. That was.
Man, I was like, yo, man. I think we want to be the best.
I don't give a fuck. Best. We want to be the best.
No matter where you are.
Anybody, I don't give a fuck who you is.
Where you want to be the best. Coming to your hood.
I take hip hop serious.
We coming to your party, your club.
I mean, coming to basement. Your party.
Yo, we be in basement parties in Brooklyn in the dark.
You get there, we going to have niggas outside, and they going to tell us when you get there, and then I'm going to grab the mic. Yo, that's on. I'm gonna get that mic and I'm gonna bring my crew up here. Hey, man.
Hold on. Let me get back down to you. Now listen, guys, you're so right. Start digga. Now, what you got to understand is niggas could hear the queen. When you put on the queen's jam, the party is going to go crazy. The block party, the club web. So once you hear her go digga, you go niggas know right there. That's the queen's jam. Because you'll go
cut that shit up. You drop it in.
Yes, you'll hear that once it goes to do, the crowd is going, yo. So the nigga, I guess the nigga probably knew the Nasty Four. See, everybody knew the Nasty. We was on the radio and stuff, guys. This is what y'all don't know. Yeah. So probably knew once you grabbed that mic, it was like Nasty Four, and he went and got the best record of them all. That's why he threw on the Queen's Jam. You don't just throw on Queen's Jam for no
reason. I never thought about that,
did you?
Because I ain't know that was right. Now I'm like,
He went and grabbed the hottest record in the crate. He probably told his man, give me Queen's
Jam. And he was cutting that shit up.
He was cutting. I remember him cutting it up. Because I remember him going, do, 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 do. And I'm like, yo, this is a do, 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 do.
I think you remember that shit, God.
Now, listen, now I'm going to catch up to the part, guys. This is why we never made it to get the mic. Nasty Four didn't get on the mic. By the time we got through the crowd to get up there, the Queens niggas, the rappers, was so mad that they had to take the mic for Daddy U. They had to get the mic back. Them niggas was mad. Oh, it was like 100 Queens niggas just converged on her like the mic from that niggas. So we never got the mic because the Nasty Four would have ripped it. By the time we got
there, the niggas was mad as fuck.
And
I'm like,
and the first thing when they took the mic,
I was young, I ain't give a fuck. But I mean,
that's all I'm about to say. Hold on, Daddy. Hold on, Daddy. Listen, guys, when they took the mic, when they snatched the mic, I could see Daddy O don't know we there. So remember, he by himself. He can't see. It's a million people. We in the crowd. He don't know we were making it through the crowd. So by the time they took the mic from, I see the niggas convert. They took the mic and he holding it. And he fighting for the mic, right? And I remember that. He fighting and niggas pulling. They pulling the cord. It's a big riot at the mic. And this nigga holding the mic. They niggas snatch the mic. He pulling it back. Them niggas, and now this nigga short and this big niggas and everything, right? So all I remember, I'm looking through the crowd and I can see the nigga fighting, pulling the mic. He's pulling the mic back. This nigga, yo, Rashawn, cut the mic, yo. Nasty Boy, cut the mic. These niggas pulling the mic. That's for this motherfucker. He like Nasty Boy in the middle. We whip shit down. They pulling the mic. He's saying his last words. So the niggas pull the mic away, right? So when the niggas pull the mic away, you see the niggas grab the mic. Hey, Queens, this Queens house. Queens, the mic. You see that? I see that. You look at them like, hey, fuck y'all niggas. I did. They did. These niggas on tour. I see that. You look like, fuck y'all niggas. I did what I came to do. Mission accomplished. This nigga like, mission accomplished, nigga. Y'all know who the Nasty Four is.
What you gonna do, nigga?
Now y'all know.
What you gonna do, nigga?
Everybody who was there, if y'all didn't know the Nasty Boys, y'all know now. Because the nigga ripped it down. A fact.
Yo, I didn't think you remembered that shit, man.
Hold on. I'm still giving you your flowers. Y'all threw that damn Queens Jam and start scratching it. And he right. That nigga start rhyming. And that nigga was stopping the record and letting it, so you know how you stop the record and let it again, so the nigga punchline to come through?
Yeah.
This nigga was stopping the record. This nigga was having a good time, and Daddy, you was killing that ish. I remember that. You was killing that ish.
Yeah.
Boy, we walking through the crowd, this nigga was like, drop, Nasty Four, South Frank, and then he's like, he'll stop the record.
Yo, what?
He'll say, I was like, oh, the crowd was going crazy too.
Yeah.
Like, so when the world would stop the record and Daddy, you would hit one of the punch signs, one of the lines, the crowd would go, whoa, and you would hear everybody go, ah, and they would do, do, I'm like, and now we, now understand, we are mic beasts. We used to call ourselves microphone fiends. That's where Rakim get that from. See, y'all got to understand hip hop history. We from Strong Island. These are Rakim days. We before Kuji Rap, before Rakim, before all of them, there was a group called the Nasty 4MCs. We was the nasties. By the time Rakim and them came on, we was in the streets selling drugs. Now, we had to stop rhyming by then. Understand, this is legendary stuff. Now, we were what we would call, you would call the microphone fiends. That's where Rakim get that from. We would fiend. That's what Daddy, you say, let me out the car. I'm getting that mic. See, now you're getting the context. Remember when I pulled up and I said, we going, Daddy, you first thing he came to the car, he looked at me in my eyes. He said, Ra, we getting that mic. I'm about to rip this shit. Let me in the car, nigga. His at a mission, microphone fiends. That's where Rakim get it from. So everywhere we go, we fiending for the microphone. We going to get that microphone.
We
going to get that mic. And we going to stamp the Nasty Four.
Bam, boom. We accept your challenge. But
oh, don't challenge us. You do not want to battle. Your best chance is to just not say anything or take anything from us. You do not want to stand against us. Now, I'm saying, listen, Daddy, I'm pointing this out because we were all microphone fiends. Daddy, you is just the beast mode. Daddy, you is like the king of the microphone. Daddy, you is just the heartbeat of I'm getting the mic. Now, when we parked that car, understand, we was headed into the party. I'm not thinking of getting the mic. I'm just letting you know, I'm thinking of going to get some checks. That's what I'm thinking. I have forgot that Daddy U was already going to get this mic. I have forgot. I know we about to go in here. We got these blunts. We about to go leave out of here with some checks, right? So we go into the park. Before we got through the gate, we hear 1-2-1-2 Nasty Boy. Right? Now, this nigga already pulls out the quickest jam. They can start rocking and the whole party is pumping. Them niggas, this shit, this nigga Daddy, you turned it out. I'm talking about the club, it was already rocking, the basketball game. This shit was so rocking that the Supreme Team niggas came in the park.
Yeah.
This is a whole fact. Everybody who was outside of the fence came in the fence to see who the hell is this nigga in our party. Listen clearly, who is this nigga in our park jam, talking about Nasty Four, grabbing our mic and ripping it. We're all just cutting it up and the crowd is going crazy. Chicks are going crazy. Crowd is going crazy. Only the people who got mad was the rappers. All the Queens niggas converged on Daddy You. The niggas just surrounded that nigga.
Yeah, what? Yeah, the niggas is saying, I'm like, man, fuck that.
They pulling the mic. They finally got the mic. Now, what I want y'all to know is when Daddy You, once he said that, we was beeline. Now I don't care about no chicks. I don't care about no weed. Once I heard that nigga say 1-2-1-2, Nasty Four in this month, oh, it's over. Microphone fiend. Michael, it's on. Nigga, we was Daddy, you didn't know we was beelining through the club. Excuse me, pardon me.
Because I did that shit so many times. And
you
so
know
many
we coming.
Spots. I'm like, all I got, people, yo, Rajon, yo, whip, people, yo.
You know we coming.
Once
he get that mic, yo, Rajon, Nasty Four.
Okay. They coming.
Daddy, let me give him some context. And we don't need four mics.
We don't need no mic.
One mic. You know, Nas, maybe all they need is one. We don't need a mic, period. But in this club setting, one mic, all four of us to stand around at one mic.
Facts. And like we're temptation.
And when my go, he'll tilt it to me. When it's Unique go, I'll tilt it to him. We know each other, so we know the routine. So us, and then when we all together, we keep it in the middle. Cause we're the vibe you love. Nasty Four MC. Are you crazy? And they're gonna pass. We're gonna just keep passing the mic with one. We don't need four mics, my dude.
We don't need to
your mic.
Yo, it got so bad. Yo, we go to Joyce and niggas,
Tell them off. He's sounding garbage. Man, niggas ain't fucking just the mic that sound good. We just huddle around that motherfucker.
The one good mic.
we learn just tools because it's like because we so nice. We ain't on this. Yo, why niggas hating us? Yo, like
I was about to say that niggas would turn off the mics.
Yeah,
that's another thing. Like, they would turn off the mics, and guess what we do then? We don't need no music. They would turn off the mics and the music, yo, and we would like, all together say it loud.
Yeah,
cause
like,
we went to their town, we went to their city, and we ripping them up so bad that niggas turn off their equipment. They turn off their mics and their music.
It is like, yo, you're the party over. Stop us.
Party over, yeah. And the crowd was like, what? And we like, party ain't over, crowd. We don't need no music. We just all four of our voices, because we're four of us and we loud. So all four of us just start doing the routine together. If we're finished, you'll be the finish. We like all four of us in one tone, ripping the shreds. Fabulous, nasty four MCs, legends. Man.
This is 25 to Life with Uncle Yahshua.
You wanna know why they call me Lucky Lucha? They call me Lucha cause I like to tuck that tuche. All the time on the grind, getting that duche.
This is a little story on 25 to Life with Uncle Yahshua. Like and subscribe for more incredible stories every week.
Police are on the scene of a triple homicide on Long Island. It happened overnight at a home in Hempstead.
I'm from Hempstead, dark side of the ghetto. The dark side, strong side, the wrong side. They think I'm supposed to be.